Hey, tech structure superstars. We have had a busy week learning about all of our tech structures, and we just talked about sequencing with frogs. I thought you'd enjoy that story. And sequencing, again, is putting things in the order that it happened. It has to make sense, otherwise it's not sequential. And there's reasons why authors put things in sequencing order, so we know the order of events. So today, what we're going to do is we are going to work on sequencing with Life Cycle of a Pumpkin. So get that out. Hopefully you've already read the passage and we're gonna go through it together. We're gonna be identifying signal words and all that good stuff that we've worked on all week. Okay, the life cycle of a pumpkin. Where does a pumpkin come from? Pumpkins grow by going through different stages. These stages are known as a life cycle. A life cycle of a pumpkin is continuous. It never ends. A pumpkin starts off as a seed, like most plants, right? The seed is planted in the dirt. If the seed gets plenty of sunlight and water, it will begin to grow roots. Next, a sprout grows from the roots. After the sprout will grow into vines. Hang on, I forgot to mark our signal words. Let's see. Next, that tells us what's happening next. After tells us that's happening after. These vines will help carry water and nutrients to the plant. Eventually, there's another signal word, a clue word that we're putting things in order. So hopefully you should be underlining these on your text. Eventually, yellow flowers will blossom on the vine. Then the flower dies and a small green pumpkin grows. Finally, the green pumpkin gets larger and grows seeds inside. It turns orange. After time, the pumpkin rots. The seeds will then sink into the ground and the cycle will begin again. Very cool. So it's never ending. And our picture here shows us the stages of the cycle and the arrows shows us which way it's going, okay? So we've got the seed, then what happens next? Sprout, grow vines, flowers die, green pumpkin, orange pumpkin, and then after the orange pumpkin dies, it rots and the seeds go into the ground and then we start all over again. How are the number one, let's make sure you have your pencil ready. How are the paragraphs in this passage connected? Question one, question two. What clue words helped you to determine this? We've been working on this format all week, so I pretty much think that you probably are an expert at it and you remember probably forever now what it means when a question says, how are these paragraphs connected? What connects them? What binds them together? What is the author trying to tell us? With our signal words, next, after, eventually, then, and finally, we know that they are connected through sequencing, through putting things in order. The paragraphs. And if you want to write the word they are connected, that's fine. Are connected because they are sequencing the pumpkin life cycle, period. All right, that is how they are connected. They're sequencing the pumpkin life cycle. Okay, part two, what clue words helped you determine this? Just like the other ones, we don't have enough space, so I'm just gonna write EX for example. And we have already done the work. We already were underlining our signal words while we were reading. So we can just write down, let's say I got space for maybe two. So we'll write down two of our signal words. After. And then. Okay, question number two, says, underline two sentences that show this connection. We're gonna do what we've been doing. We're gonna underline and then not write them since we've already identified them. So it says two sentences that show this connection, the sequencing. Well, that should be pretty easy because we already have our signal words. So we can just underline two sentences that have our signal words in them. So I'm gonna go back up to the text. You can underline the same ones I have or pick different ones, however you want. So this shows me we're sequencing because it says next and finally, because that shows it's happening last. You could have underlined the other sentences too, or you can underline them all if you want. So these signal words are showing us that the author has set this text up as a sequence to show us the order of the life cycle of the pumpkin. Okay, let's look at number three. What will happen to a pumpkin to a pumpkin seed if it gets sunlight and water? What will happen if it gets sunlight and water? That's kind of like a cause and effect. However, the majority of the text is sequencing. So I'm gonna go back into the text. What will happen to a pumpkin seed if it gets sunlight and water? So I'm gonna slide over again. And it's talking about pumpkin seed, and I know the seed is the first step, so I'm gonna start at the kind of the top of the text and look for that word seed. Oh, right there. A pumpkin starts off as a seed. The seed is planted in the dirt. If a seed gets plenty of sunlight and water, it will begin to grow roots. We got our answer pretty easily, right? So if it gets sunlight and water, it will begin to grow roots. So sunlight and water first, then roots. Okay, choice A, the seed will sprout. No, we just read it will grow roots, which is part B. Let's read all of our choices, though. Just get into that good habit. The seed will turn orange. No, the seed will grow a flower. No, B is our best answer. It's the only answer. Okay, number four, explain why the life cycle of a pumpkin is described as a cycle. Well, what is a cycle? What's a bicycle? The wheels go what? Round and round and round and round. So a cycle, round and round and round it goes because it never ends. Because remember, when the pumpkin turns orange, then it starts to rot, the seeds go in the ground and starts to grow another pumpkin. It is a cycle because it never ends, period. After the pumpkin rots, the seeds go into the ground and it starts all over again, period. So that's why it's a cycle. It goes round and round and round. If you're ready to read number five, go ahead. Start looking for that answer. Okay, number five. What happens after the pumpkin turns orange? Well, my word that sticks out to me in that sentence is orange. So I'm gonna scan and try to find orange. What happens after? What happens after the pumpkin? So the pumpkin's gotta turn orange, and then what happens right after that? So let's go back and find orange. I know it turns orange at the end, so I'm gonna kinda look towards the end of my passage. Orange, orange, orange. Oh, there it is, there's the word orange. Okay. It turns orange. After time, the pumpkin rots. The seeds will then sink into the ground. The cycle will begin again. So what happens after it turns orange? Right after it, it says the pumpkin rots. After the pumpkin turns orange, it will rot.
Period.
All right, let's look at the last question. What happens right before flowers bloom on the plant? So we need to go back into the text, find when the flowers bloom, and then read what happened before it. So after the flowers bloom, right before the flowers bloom. Before the flowers bloom, okay. Next, a sprout grows from the roots. The sprout will grow into vines. These help carry water and nutrients. Eventually flowers will blossom on the vine. And the question is what happens before that? So we need to go back and read what happened before that. Okay, so here's where the flowers are and we need to read before. Next, a sprout grows from the roots. After the sprout will grow into vines, these vines help carry water and nutrients to the plant. So what happens before the flowers? They grow vines, right. Okay. Oh, that's the first answer choice. So that's definitely a maybe. Let's read them all. The flower dies. No, that doesn't happen before it blooms. A sprout grows. No, it does, but the question is asking what happens right before. And the pumpkin rots. No, that's at the end. So answer choice A. Very good. Again, cut it out. Glue it in your reading notebook so you've got your signal words for sequencing. And we are all done with our text structure this week. So you are going to take a quiz and it's going to look like this. You're gonna have to go back onto Schoology. Now, if you can't print it, that's okay. You can just write your answer choices on a sheet of paper and then go back and type them in. So the first part, I've already done that for you. Those are the five text structures. The bottom part, you're going to have these questions and you see lines on top of the little tiny passage you're going to read. The lines are where you're going to write your answer. So one of these is going to be cause and effect, one is going to be sequence, one is going to be problem solution, one will be description, and one will be compare and contrast. So if this one is cause and effect, you would write cause and effect on the line, okay? You're only going to use each answer choice one time. And if you get to the last one and say you have problem and solution left over and it doesn't match the text at all, then you've made a mistake in another one. That's why you should be writing in a pencil. Erase it, and then you're just gonna have to go back and check. So if you can't print, you just write your answers on a piece of paper and then you can go back and type them in. Same thing for you. If you can print, write them down, but you have to go back into Schoology and type them in, otherwise I won't know you did it. Okay? I think you'll be okay. Text structure is something we're going to talk about all year, so you've gotten to become really good with it. And just remember, when it's asking how paragraphs are connected, that means what text structure is the author using. All right, happy Friday. Have a great weekend. Do your work.